What? No question. Okay, Georgic, is your time. So ask, do some question to this idiot on YouTube. So I got an old IBM ThinkPad. And you got a motherboard with 1.8 gigahertz CPU with 4 megabyte cache. So the question here is the biggest question about all kind of modern CPUs. So which one is the better? Higher frequency with lower cache or higher cache with lower frequency? Let me tell you, I'm dealing with computers more than, 25 years or even 30 years, something like this. And what I realized is, if you believe or not, but what is meaning the most is the cache and the level of the cache. This 2.5 gigahertz with 6 megabyte cache, I think it's a bit outdated today. If you just play some stupid game, almost everything depend on a cache. More depend on a cache, like what you think. So from this choice, what you have, I think the best for both of the way is the 2.5 gigahertz with 6 megabyte cache. If you're learning now C++, programming, it's depend on your development platform. So if you're using a most modern Microsoft Visual Studio, then forgot this old hardware. You will suck with the database programming, you will suck with the database interfacing, you will suck with everything. But if you are using some kind of other tools, I don't know who have, I always use the Visual Studio, I don't know, full package, whatever, even now I have installed something. I think the latest one I have, and this is eating the computer. So when you do a programming and you wanna try out on your platform or your virtual server platform, which is running inside in a Visual Studio, then it's like, this is how it's eating up your computer. Go to some cheap notebook store and buy a new one, because the latest programming technology want to use the latest hardware technology. If you, let's say, develop some software on some old hardware, you cannot be sure your future clients will be happy with the software, because maybe you just importing a wrong modules, because nowadays all the programming is just about importing half ready modules and then just jiggling around. I don't know. Don't play with shit. So if you're a programmer, don't play with shit, because two things is really matter when you do a programming. And what you guess, what is the first, is the time. So how much time you spend on a programming, and how much time you spend on a testing, and how much time you spend on a repair or on a lines of the codes. So if you have a slow hardware, which is not supporting you, then all of your development will be really annoying and slow and whatever. Last week, we find a really decent notebook from Dell, if I remember good. It's a Lenovo for €499 here in Europe, and freaking amazing. So 8 gigabyte of RAM, modern technology, USB 3, I don't know, you know, 4-core and blah, 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 core i5. My last words about it. So if you are programming, take your hobby or your job seriously. In the past, I did a lot of programming for really special hardwares, for servers, for database programming, and for even artificial intelligence business kind of solution, what I developed. And I always, when I get slow because of my softwares and the hardwares, it's like I always just dropped. I sold it immediately and I bought the latest technology. I want to buy a computer screen for gaming. Oron, we just bought for you what this Ijama monitor. But if you want to take seriously the gaming, let me show you what the serious gamers are using. Yeah, well, this is the best monitor for gaming, believe me. Oron asked me, why are you saving money all the time? I'm stabbed in some kind of development. And I want to release something on the market. This development, it will be cost a bit more than what I thought on the beginning. I just checked some kind of hardware development cost estimation, Excel sheets on the internet from really professional people who start to develop something alone. So not like in a big company with a huge bank account on the back. And what I read over there, at first, you know, I said, what is this bullshit? It's stupidity. And then I, you know, I digged inside a bit and then, yeah, really. So this is why a lot of young players have failed on the Kickstarter. Yeah, they say, oh, for 100,000 euro, we can develop this and this and this and this and this, and they never can release the real products. But they start to eat the money from the account. So then they are failing, and then they are facing with really heavy curse on a judge. And this I don't want to do. So I'm just going forward step by step. I do a lot of research, and I just collecting information, and in the background, somewhere here, I do a development slowly, and I optimizing things in my head, and then take my plans and I redraw something and blah, blah, blah. So this is why I'm saving money. Jojic, I wanted to make a neat machine for Linux, for internet browsing and movies. Okay, Jojic. Linux and movies? No. I had a really bad experience with that. And just one example with internet and Linux and movies. If you know, please tell me, because I'm also interested in that. If you know a good Java system for Linux, which is not crashing on you, which is not dying on you, what can handle the real Java packages from websites, and what can communicate with video servers, please send me in a private message the name of this sudo get, whatever, how I can get it, because I couldn't find one which is stable, and it can provide me a same user experiments like the Windows. Just don't forget, lot of audio interfaces are not supported by Linux. Lot of video spatial interfaces are not supported by Linux. And I think Linux is, it will die on the reason why the Linux is burned and why the Linux is good in a past. Linux is like, it looks to me like we have around 100,000 genius, really genius, hacker, modern programmer, whatever, who really know the core of the Linux and how the Linux is working. And then we have about 10-20 million, I don't wanna attack nobody, but we have 20 million other kind of Linux people. And from that, this, you get something. And then, look, you can see that problems already, how much distribution you have. So when, for example, you want to make a nice and stable voice over IP phone central system, Then this module need Red Hat. This one need Fedora. This one need this. This one need this. And then you have to download and install a lot of libraries. But this library is not compatible with the other library. And why? I always ask from my Linux friends, why you guys not made only one distribution, which is called Linux, and that's it. So then I can imagine if this 100,000 really heavy Linux programmer working only on one distribution, then I'm telling you, the Linux can kill everybody on a market, including the Microsoft and Apple and everybody. No, you guys need this distribution, this version, this version, this. Why? Why the Linux have, I don't know how many desktop graphic user interface. Why? Why just not one? I'm only using the Linux for really certain applications, like for routers, file servers, security application, and for this voice over IP telephone centras. That's all. Somebody told me the Ubuntu is the best and the most stable and the most valid and blah, 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 blah. Let me tell you, I cannot use the Ubuntu for basic, really basic applications. Here we're starting, yeah? So choose one. And this is what I'm really hate about the Linux community. I don't know those guys, why not making like Linux server and Linux client. That's it. And that's it. It will solve all the problem around the Linux, all, including how to get a part of the market on a computer business. Because this way, you see, this will earn, I don't know, this will earn 10,000 euro, this will earn 100 million euro, this will earn 0 euro, whatever. Why? So if you compare this to the Apple, it's like, or if you, and you know, the joke about this, why I'm saying to compare to the Apple, what you think was the base of the Apple operating system? Unix. You feel the joke here? I don't think so. In this way, Linux anytime will reach anything on this world, like, no way. The joke is that Microsoft will die faster than Linux. Jogic, no. Microsoft, first of all, never will die. They have a lot of money. They have a lot of brains, amazing guys working for a Microsoft. If you checking now the new development platforms from Microsoft, you will be amazed, because a lot of things is running around the Linux. So just prepare yourself what will happen here about Microsoft and Linux. Microsoft never will die. Even Apple cannot be exist today if the Microsoft not give them a lot of money in the past. Actually, the Apple, why it's existing here nowadays on the market, because Bill Gates gave a lot of money to the Apple to start their business. Everybody just say about Microsoft and say a lot of thank you for the Microsoft, because without the Microsoft, you not see here now this quality of hardware and this amount of computing powers and this amount of solutions and this kind of website, nothing. Do you often use your spectrum analyzer, which you repaired? Yeah, I'm using a lot. It's actually not a spectrum analyzer. It's much more than a spectrum analyzer. It's helped me a lot to find the best position for the PA speakers, because this party place is not a simple place. This party place, it's unfortunately, is total asymmetric. And so what's the problem with this place? This bar is, it's almost exactly on the middle of the space, and here on the top we have some kind of second level, which is like 6 meter wide and 15 meter long and other 20 something meter long. So, and we have to focus, maybe here you can see, we have to focus all the sound to here, and this is what we choose as a dense area. I hope you can see my mouse. And because of that, it's, you can see even the angle of the speakers are calculated. So it's not just one angle, it have two angle. This one have a other angle, and here what we did, here what we did in other corner, here you can see when I did a welding job. And here what you can see again, this is we drilled to the specific angle, three rods, and then we adjust again the other angle with these two top rods. So because of this really asymmetrical place here on the middle, and this is what we choose like a dancing area, I have to be really smart about speaker adjustment and placement. And so then you can imagine this height here, for example, it's 10 meter, but this height here is just 8 meter 20, something like this. And this one, it's about 6 meter 90, if I remember good. And you see everywhere glass and whatever. So unfortunately, in this club, I cannot do a really good acoustic treatment because of the design and because of the shape of the room. So because of that, I used a lot, like I think I used about more than 30 hours to figure out specific problems here on the middle where people are dancing. This Goldline RTA, I'm telling you, is the best. It's an old technology, it's nothing fancy, it's just, you saw that on a video. It's amazing how it's working, and it's like a tool. So this is not a joke device. In the past, I cannot afford because of the price. It's in the past like, I don't know, like 4,000 euro, something like this. Even today is running on 2,600. Let me check. Okay, I think because I'm not sure, because I got the carry case and the software and SDIC, everything, but with the MK8 microphone, I cannot say to you guys, this is what I have. So even today, this tool, it's about freaking $2,565. Of course, plus tax, plus toll, plus everything if you import it into the Europe. So I think I'm really lucky with that on eBay. I'm really lucky with that for 120 euro, if I remember good. Looks like Party Place is some kind of industrial zone. Yeah, it's absolutely industrial. Is in the past, is some kind of repair station for rail wagons and for rail engines, so railway, the Deutsche Bahn. One day ago, I'm just so stupid, I find the big brother of this Goldline RTA on eBay. It started on 1 euro, of course, nothing wrong with the unit, and I just miss it. I went out to smoke, and I start to talk with somebody, I start to eat, and I went to the gas station to fill up my car, and on the gas station I said something, I forgot something. So I filled my car, and when I came back, and then, you know, like a face spam, like the biggest face spam, I forgot this freaking Goldline heavy RTA measurement unit. Let me show you. So this is what I forgot to follow on eBay, and yeah, this is a really massive, really professional unit, and I just so stupid. I miss it because of nothing, not because of the money. You know where it's stubbed? It's stubbed on 162 euro, which is nothing. Nothing for this unit, and I'm so stupid. I want to make for you guys a new video about this new RTA catching on eBay. And okay, Vilnius ask about what you think about room correction devices. Very good question. So the room correction, if you do alone the room correction on your frequency response of your output to the speaker, you are on a wrong way. The frequency problems with your room is not came from the speaker. It came from your room and from your reflections. If you touch the frequencies with EQ, then these frequencies will not exist in your room at all. The room correction devices, let's say they can help on your acoustic treatment, and your acoustic treatment is helping on your room correction, which is done by some kind of DSP or by software or filters or EQs and whatever. Anybody who came to my old studio and they sit down and they listen some mixes, they said, what the fuck, it's this room is like, they said, so this is not my word, they said my studio is really sounds like a studio, but not dry like a studio, so they feel comfortably, and I feel the mixes really well, like how they will hear at home. I did a really interesting acoustic treatment in my old studio. Unfortunately, we demolished all the shit over there on a Frankfurter Allee, and in a new place I have other kind of deep problem with the height of my studio. So in the past, I also used some kind of room correction software. The results is horrible. Even enough, if you just change your sitting and listening position 5 centimeters. And then gone, the guitar is gone, complete guitar is gone. And then I change my head position like back to 10 centimeters. Then the kick drum is missed, then this missed, and no. Room correction softwares and this signal processing solution is just helping on the acoustic treatment. But if you are home studio, there is no way you sit down with, you buy some kind of monitor speaker and you place into your room in a dry room what you are using daily for example, for sleep, for eat, for drink or whatever, and you do a mix over there. For that application, you will get much more better results if you spend even 600 or 1,000 euro on a good headphone, and you do all of the mixes on your headphone alone, and when your mix is ready and done, you just jump to somewhere else to listen on different speakers. And then you adopt the main problems with your mix again with headphone, and you have to learn how your headphone is working together with your ears and with your head. If you have a really absolutely best acoustic treatment, and the price is the sky, but you never can be sure, even with the most highest high-end acoustic treatment in your studio, it will be good enough. And of course, because of that, you have to apply some kind of EQing and room correction. Don't be afraid and just wait a bit. I don't know how much time. Paul, if Paul is here, I don't know what he say, but we will have a solution for room correction and for speaker correction and for listening environment and for measurement and RTA checking and everything. Actually, the product that we developing now, it's one part of my product is about this. So if you wait a bit, you will see some kind of solution from me. Until that, I don't know. I even don't want to say brands or solutions or DSPs and EQs or whatever to which kind of room correction is the best for you. Nice. Here is one situation. You cannot do nothing with this room, with room correction at all. No way. So what you see here, maybe you think these differences is coming like this is louder, this is softer, so these frequencies, you see the numbers, you see the crazy numbers. We're talking about 30, 40 dB differences in certain frequencies. And of course, how the frequency is going higher and higher and higher, then you have more weird and more rapid problems. And don't forget the frequency range, okay? So the frequency difference between this and this, it's only 50. So this, we're talking about logarithmic scale. So we have one issue, two issue, three, four, five, I don't know, 10 issue on 50 hertz. Okay. May you think, oh, between 100 and 200, we have a same. No, but this here, it's 100 hertz. So the same distance what you see visually here and here is doubled. So how your frequency is going up and up and up and up, if this is the situation with your room, of course nothing is coming from absorption or from something is eating the sound on certain frequencies. All this, if you believe or not, all this is phase issues. So maybe this one, this big bump here, for example, here you see, the highest level is 130 and the lowest is under 85. So we're talking about 50 decibel. 50 decibel, it's like you turn your volume knob to the minimum. It's about 64 decibel, I think, in almost all hi-fi and whatever speaker. So when you turn your hi-fi to the maximum, and then you turn back to the minimum, barely you just hear something. Now we're talking about 62 decibel difference. This problem is not coming from some bird or rat or dog or cat is eating some frequencies. No, all this coming from the reflections, from the delayed reflections, from corners and from something. And this you never ever can corrugate with any kind of EQ or DSP or magic or, I don't know, with voodoo or with Jedi things. No way. First, what you have to do always is always do a really basic measurement. And when you see something like this, what you see here now, yeah? When you see something like this, you can be sure you have to apply a lot of treatment in your room. And then maybe if these differences start to come like only 10 dB or 6 dB or 3 dB per octave problems, and all of these weird artifacts are disappearing, then you can start to do a room correction. Why? Because other problem with the room correction. Everything, all room correction is based on frequency corrections and also on phase and timing and whatever. The newest technologies are unbelievably sophisticated too, and they're tricking a lot with the sound on. Even I cannot understand how is dealing with that, because the main correction is EQ. Then, of course, you cannot do more EQing, like, which is, let's say, normal and really natural and transparent, like 6 dB or 3 dB per certain frequency. This is why I have this BSS 966. This is why I'm like it. You have a constant Q per frequency. Let me show you how much room correction I have to do in my old studio. this is the amount of correction what I had to do in my old studio. You see that? Just check this, yeah? And here I have some kind of problem because of the wrong placement of my listening position, really. And later on I realized that, and this one here is changed to the position somewhere here, and this one came much more lower, so I still have this bump. Maybe you can see here this bump. Okay, then I realized I have some problem here, so then I did the changing. I just simply, if you believe or not, I just simply adjusted the height of my seat with 12 centimeter, and then this one is also almost gone. It just came like this. So this is the amount of frequency correction in my old studio, what I have to apply. You see this? It's almost flat on the top, and this is made for the NS10X monitor. Of course, on the bottom, I did a lot of cut. Even here, you can see where is the high pass filter, and I applied some kind of contour because of the NS10 monitor. You know, guys, on the bottom end, the NS10, it's not so powerful, but it's really tight and really precise. So because of that, I played a lot with the filters and with this contouring. But on the end, we're talking about from 200 hertz. This is this problematic area. From here up to the 20K, like flat. And this is what is mean, what you have to achieve with simple acoustic treatment. And I'm telling you guys, the whole cost of my acoustic treatment in my old studio is not cost more like 400 euro, because I find everything in a garbage and it works. So this is how you can do a really nice acoustic treatment with really simple basic measurements. And for that, you must need a measurement microphone. You cannot do on other way. I'm very excited to see your solution product. Oh yeah, I will be more excited than you when I see my product is done and is on my table and is working and the magic smoke is not coming out from the back. So yeah, you guys will see it. So you can do this software based too. Yeah, you know, guys, why I arrived on the end to this Opal EQ. Because this one you don't have to load, and this one you don't have to save the presets, nothing. One time you adjusted, this is always there, and you just have to switch on and switch off. Maybe if I switch off the chat, here you can see, you just have to switch on and switch off the EQ. You see that? How simple is that? And this EQ is really transparent. I really like the sound of this EQ. Time to time, I'm also using on mastering. Believe me, it sounds great and sounds fantastic. And no hiss, no noise. And of course, I tried different softwares. I'm not quite happy with the results. And maybe because of my stupid air, yeah? But I heard something is going through some calculations, and everything is arrived to my ear like a bit delayed, and I heard really weird things what I don't want to hear at all, and then later on I get confused with my mix. So now the acoustic is on or off, this plugin is on and off. So when I checked everything via headphone, I of course I have to take out from the chain. And no, guys, if you can do on a hardware way. And this is why my product will be really, really, really interesting. Okay, so yeah. And the other problem with the software solutions, I think it's really specified on me, this kind of problem. You know, guys, my main DAW system and my favorite music creation system is The Reason. And for The Reason, there is no VST plugin support. So no one of the room correction software is running under Reason. Under the Cubase, of course, everything is working. You can load and you can do a new measurement, whatever. But under Reason, no. So in the past, I used, because of that only, I had some kind of software solution between the Reason and between the Cubase, which is passed the audio to the Cubase, and then I inserted the room correction, and I listened on the output of the Cubase, and no. So then I realized I need a really nice sounding graphical EQ, and then I solved the problem. That's it. I haven't seen all of your videos yet. Sorry, I discovered you not so long ago. Yeah, if Vilnius, if you can do, check my old videos. I think on the beginning, maybe I'm not so professional on YouTube and I spoke a lot. So my first videos is like 1 hour long and 1.5 hour long, even, I don't know, because I want to give you guys a lot of information. And I even cannot understand how people can make videos in 10 minutes or in 15 minutes. Then, okay, check my old videos, have a fun with that. And I really appreciate this. And did you resolve the problems with the Yamaha? This you mean? This one. Ah, okay, now I get it. Okay, let me jump back. No. So I can't solve the problem. I can't solve the problem. The problem is still exists. For example, yesterday I want to record some really crazy GTA events. I find some friends on a GTA 5 online game, and yesterday I want to record something really interesting together with the music and with the speaking and screaming, you know, all this shit. I don't want to release on YouTube, it's just for fun. And of course, in the middle of the game, like, we spend like half an hour of the setup of what we want to do in a GTA 5. We spend a half an hour to bring there everything, and then we start the event, and my freaking stupid Yamaha AG06 mixer is frozen on me, but on the baddest way. So the screen capture is frozen. And then after 2 seconds or 5 seconds, something like this, the GTA 5 is also frozen. And then I get some alert on my screen by the Rockstar. You are using some kind of cheater software, so we are kick you. So this is what happened. I don't know what they saw about that. Actually, I really like it. You see, now it's on my table. Let's say now it's under test, yeah? So I tried to use, but somehow I don't want to say fucking, but I will say fucking, but this fucking DSP software controller, not the DSP itself, the software, even on my high-end, high-level workstation, is loses the connection to this shit. So I don't know what's going on now. Let me check. I hope it's not frozen. No one of the is working again. And nothing is working. That's it. I think Yamaha, they lose their mind with this product. Maybe they invited some wrong programmer, or maybe the programmer did the programming on some low-end laptop with Core 2 CPU. You know somebody who want to do a programming on a shitty laptop? No? So maybe the guy who did and developed the driver between the computer and between the DSP processor, this is his fail. So I don't want to speak too much about this Yamaha. You see, again, it's frozen on me. hopefully I'm not playing now with GTA 5. So let's, no, I even don't want to close it, because if I'm close it, I don't know what will happen. I have a 3.5 millimeter lavalier microphone and the USB audio interface. I cannot get my lavalier mic to work with it. Oh yeah, Tim, please send me in a googly moogly here in a YouTube a private message about the type and the brand of your lavalier mic, because it's the lavalier mics are really, really interesting. So the Beyer Dynamic is using different kind, Sennheiser is using different kind, and the Sony is using different kind. And so on the lavalier mics, it's always like they developed their lavalier mic for their own product mostly, and they all sounds great. I'm talking about the major companies, the major brands. And if your lavalier mic is working on 48 volt, then you have to support 48 volt. But it's really depend on the number and the brand of your lavalier mic. I saw one which is run only on 12 volt, and somebody fitted with 48 volt, sorry, and of course inside the mic is it's blowed up and nothing sign. Like, you even when you measured, it showed something, and even when you touch the capsule like this, it did something, but not picked up nothing. So don't try. So please first send me, and then I will look after it, and I will say you what you need for that. And I also saw one which is run on only on one AA battery. So talking about 1 volt, is the Sony ACM52, something like this. I have one from the Sony, the ACM55. Let's say it's a vintage lavalier mic, and I'm really lucky with that, because I can power with one AA battery and also with phantom power. 44, something like this. So inside into this capsule, you can drop a AA battery. The 3.5 millimeter jack is designed for me. It's made for this kind of solutions, yeah? So this is also a lavalier mic, you see the end. This is a Sennheiser. And yeah, in this end, it looks absolutely like a normal 3.5 millimeter jack, but is not true. I think the outer ring, this one, is 10 volt or 8 volt. I don't know. Even they're not telling you how much volt. So easily can be some kind of special lavalier mic, and you need a really special end for it, but we can figure out if we find some information on the microphone. Tim, don't try, because you will kill something, or your audio interface or your microphone. You will kill it, believe me. So don't try too much. What is the best thing you find in a garbage? My best find in a garbage is in the past a car. In Hungary, I find a car in a garbage. Is some Fiat black, really high level, new, almost new Fiat, what we find in a garbage. we totally killed out, and then later on the police came for it, and they picked up, and they said somebody stolen this car in Italy. And okay, so this is my best find in the garbage. On audio related, can I say maybe this heavy big monitor speakers what we find the last time, and what we modified with Paul together. The video is on my channel. And I also find in a garbage this old organ. And what we find in the garbage? I find a lot of things, and I always just check it, and if I like it, I repair it. If I don't like it, I just demolish it, and I use parts inside. monitors, TVs, speakers, amplifiers, mixers, everything. And even furnitures, chairs, and bed, and everything. You cannot believe here in Germany, in Berlin, what you can find in a, on a street, on a garbage, really. A full motorbike. One time we find a full motorbike, a small scooter, of course, nothing Suzuki GSX-er or something, a full motorbike in working condition, the key is inside. We did install and it's rotted on it. It's for Geschenk, yeah? So you can take it. So we take it. And yeah, it's really cool what you can find in the garbage. And don't be feel like shy. If you see something which is good for you, don't forget with that. Maybe you can help also for the nature, because then it's not going to the processing of the garbage. So maybe you can save something on a planet. Maybe a small plant button is pressed on the individual pole. Yeah. Maybe the small pad button is pressed on the interface. You know how many times I'm not talking about YouTube live in and with this Yamaha mixer. Yeah. I don't know who invented this 20 dB pad on the mixers, but I want to kill him. You know, I arrived to somewhere with my big, heavy FOH mixer, yeah? You can imagine, yeah? The band is there, girls are running, a lot of microphone is plugged, guitars, amplifiers, effects, and whatever. We start the session and... Oh, where is the... Why I cannot hear the... Fortunately, in that time, what I'm talking about, the specific event, is the rock band. And the singer, he's up. Amazing, you know, this big heavy voice like this, and fortunately he can overshoot without a microphone the band, so even nobody recognized there is some problem with the microphone. I just hear it in my headphone, and you know, I see it in front of the house FOH mixer, this is what I try to figure what the fuck, something is wrong. And my friend came to there and he said, what is this button? What is this? And I look on it, fucking pad. And I tap on it and everything, it just came to be right. I think not I'm alone, the audio engineer on a planet who sucked with the pad button. I don't know. I totally agree with you. I found some good stuff in the garbage. My country, Latvia. Ah, you came from Latvia. Ah, I don't know why I have a Latvian visitor. Welcome here. Is much poorer than Germany. I don't think so. One time I've been there in Latvia. I really love your country. Amazing. The girls are so beautiful and the mountains. And oh my gosh. Thumbs up for your country. I really like it. Mostly the girls, like, wow. Really. And so your country is really rich, but still people are too lazy to fix good stuff. Yeah, this is like, I think this is a really big problem now, and this is why we saw so many garbage, really industrial and really heavy garbage, because people don't want to fix nothing. You know what? Also, the products are made like this. Can you open iPhone 6 to repair? Where is the screw? I think this is a really big problem. Jogik, looks like BMR is popular between Lithuanians. I'm in Riga right now as well. Ah, Jogik and Vilnius. You guys, be a friend. I hope after this talking on my YouTube channel, you guys will pick up the contacts from each other, because both of you guys, it's something really fantastic, and I really like this on a YouTube, about the YouTube. You guys in the same city and you guys are watching the same YouTube channel, a same idiot. So please guys, contact together and go together to drink something and spoke about something, and I don't know. I'm really happy about this Amazing, amazing. If they somehow bought new cars, they all made for anti-repair attitude. Best comment today. Anti-repair attitude. Please prepare yourself for the next live event. Thank you very much for watching me on this shitty live stream event or whatever. So guys, really appreciate that, and see you next time. I think the streaming will stay here a bit just for testing because I want to deal with this DSP issue and I want to do some kind of measurement with that. Come on, no, you can do it. Bye, guys.